What's up, y'all? But doing my homework and finishing my burger, you feel me? But I just wanted to, you know, tell this story and not necessarily get off my chest, but I found it funny. And I woke up this morning, I was like, I want to tell a story today. So that's how we feeling. I mean, I'm not gonna say no names, like I'm not gonna say no real names, but we're just gonna start off by addressing him as Dylan, you know? So yeah. So you know, I was a little freshy or whatever. And you know, there's a cute guy. And his name is Dylan. And he's fine, like he's chocolate, tall, football, fine, you know? So, we would talk at school sometimes, but you know, not all the time. So I was like, okay, you know, cool. So, he graduated, you know, he went on by his life, and I was like, I'm never gonna see him again. So fast forward, coming, I'm about to be a senior, you feel? So, it was a Sunday before school, because I don't know when school started, but it was the Sunday before school started, and we had went to church, me and my mom and my baby brother, we went to church, and after church, it was like, go sign your child up for football or whatever. So my mom was like, Corey, you want to do it? So he was like, yeah, you know, yeah, mama, I want to do it. So I was like, okay, I guess we're going. So we went home, I went to change my shoes, still in my church clothes, and some cute jeans and a white shirt. I'm gonna put it up somewhere so y'all can see, because oh, I was looking good today. But yeah, after that, we had went to the park and walked in the building, because it's a building like outside the park. I walk in, I kid you not, I turned to my left and I saw Dylan, and then my mind dropped, and I was like, I turned around, I said, look me in my head. I was like, I said, who?
Smoking on these woods got me high than a bitch.
I said, hold on, let me make sure that's Dylan. So I turn around, I'm like, dancing in my head. So I turn around, I said, oh my God, this Dylan, he's so fine, like, just like I remember. White shirt, shorts. He had that flannel on, so he kept putting it down. I guess I wouldn't notice that he was looking at me, but I noticed you. I noticed. So they had sized my brother up or whatever, and I went outside because I just couldn't be in there. So, you know, after that, I went outside and I called my friend, and I was like,
hey, keep a girl, like. Guess who's here? Like, you don't know who he is, but he's here. And then she was like, who, girl? Who? And then I was like, it's Dylan. And then she was like, Dylan, who done? So I sent her a picture, and she was like, oh, shit. So I'm looking at the phone like,
did she just say Dylan was all right? I said, no, you must be spoken to him because baby Dylan is fine. He's fine. He's fine. You're fine. So, huh? So after that, he had came outside, and I was like, oh my God, why is Dylan outside? Why is he outside? He's playing football with his brother. So he came up to me, he was like, that's your brother. And I was like, in my head, I was like,
got me higher than a bitch. Hi. 3+3.
But then I was like, yeah, that's my brother. He's like, oh, okay. And then my mom was like, let's go, because I guess she finished signing the papers and stuff. And then he didn't wave at me. He kind of just, you know, smiled at me.
I was like,
who?
You know,
I was
like,
who?
You know,
I
was like,
after that, we got home. I waited for like 2 hours before I went on his Instagram. And I went on in like one of his pictures, because he didn't post no pictures, and I was like, bitch, why you don't post pictures? So yeah. And then like 25, maybe 30 minutes later, he DM'd me, and I had a post. on my Insta and it was like, if you want me to speak up. And he was like, who that for? Like, I'm gonna put the messages somewhere because I got the receipts. You feel me? So, yeah, so we have been talking. And then he was like, long story short, he was like, call me. So I had texted him and then he was like, let's FaceTime. And then we FaceTime me, you know, it's like 8 o'clock at night. I got school tomorrow. I'm in my bonnet, my tank top, my booty shorts. You know, like, it's time for me to go to bed. And he talking about some last FaceTime. I was like, nigga, what? But, you know, you fine. So, you an exception. So, yeah. So, I started going to the practices and stuff. And he was the coach or whatever. So, I was like, who? Bet of you. So, after that, I just started going to the practices and stuff, not only supporting my brother, but, you know, supporting this good-looking chocolate dude, you know? So, I got close to the mom, I got close to the daddy, the brother, and the sister, and I was like, ooh, and he got close to my mama, and I was like, and he got close to my brothers, and I was like, yo.
He swag dip, smoking on these woods.
Yo. And I was just like, Lord, everything going out smooth. But I came to the conclusion, and I was like, man, we really getting close. Maybe we should, like, talk. So we had got serious. That's not our first time we had got serious, though. But we had was talking about, like, us. And I was like, well, what are we doing? And he was like, well, I like you and you like me because he had said, like, he always liked me. And in my head, I was like, you always like me? I was a freshman. You was a senior. Stop capping. And he was like, I'm not lying. I always liked you. And I was like, okay, whatever. But yeah. So, I was like, so what are we doing? Like, why we don't try it out? And he was like, oh, I don't want to tie you down because I want you to find somebody better. And I was like, maybe you're better. I want you. So then he's like, okay, maybe we could build like our friendship up and see where we go from there. So I was like, you know, he thinking like a mature person. So I was like, you know, it's all good, you know, in the hood. I was like, yeah. So I was like, we're building our friendship and stuff. He coming to the house and chill, you know, and we were just like big chilling, you know, like getting close. So go to all the practices, we hug it out. We always on the phone, always talking and stuff. He got close to my brothers. I got close with his mom, like his family and stuff. I was like, everything cool. Like, it's working out. Y'all. In this moment, he knew he fucked up. Y'all. Let me tell y'all how God worked in mysterious freaking ways. Let me tell y'all. Y'all wanna know? Do y'all wanna know? I'm about to tell y'all. So, it's the last game, y'all. It's a Tuesday, the last epic game. I had just got back from the mall with my friend because it was a Tuesday and we had school. I think we had parents in Chicago that day, so we didn't have school. So, my friend came in and we went to the mall, you know.
When your friend's smoking, you know what it smells like in our car.
So, then, I had got mad about something. When we went to the game, I got mad about something. And he came up to me, he gave me a hug, asked me about my day. And so I was looking good and stuff, and I was like, So yeah, so after that, it started raining, so we went under the bleachers. Like under it, because the way the bleachers are set up, they got like this under thing where the bathroom's at. So we went under there. And then it stopped, so I went back up with the bleachers. And I'm texting my friend Zion, my friend Asian, you know. And I'm watching the game at the same time. So, you know, I'm like, something told me, like something whispered in my ear was like, Taz, look to your left. Look to your left. So I'm looking, you know, I'm slowly turning my head to the left. And I see his system, and I was like, well, she in her uniform, she probably just came back from my game or whatever. So then I looked some more, and I was like, we just gonna call her Anna. So I was like, oh, it's Anna. So I was like, no, Anna, do my VR. So, because I have been knowing Anna since middle school. Like, she really cool people. Like, I wouldn't say we best friends, but you know, we friends. So I was like, I'm paying attention to my brother, and I'm gonna just talk to her later.
So she came up to me. She was like, hey, how you doing? I miss you, because she had graduated. And I was like, what's up, girl? You know, I miss you too. And I was just catching up and stuff.
So 5, maybe 10 minutes after that, she had took a step. And I was like, well, she about to go so I could videotape my brother. So she turned back around. And she was like, and I quote,
so my boo bear gonna be mad that I'm here, but it's okay, I came to surprise him.
I said, what now? Oh, so.
My poo bear is gonna be mad that I'm here, but you know, it's okay, I can't surprise him.
So I'm looking at him, I'm like, who you poo bear, girl? Like, I'm thinking I'm man, like in the bleachers or some stuff. My poo bear over there. So I'm looking. I said, she pointing in the direction of Dylan. I said, no. I said, that poo bear? She said, yeah, girl. I said, Coach poo bear? Dice skin poo bear? Tall, fine poo bear. Look me.
God! Wow!
Girl, I'm so happy for you. Oh my God. Yes, bitch. Yes, you did good, girl. In my head, I was like, oh. I was so mad, y'all. My legs started shaking. My arms started twitching. I was like, the fuck? And then in that moment, I wanted to just, you know, but I was like, it's not her, because she probably don't know. So I was like, I was this close when I tell you. And then I called Zaya right after, and then Zaya was like, Taz, don't do it. I called Kiba. Kiba was like, Taz, don't do it. I was right on the rail. I grabbed the rail and I was like, I'm about to jump this kid and beat his ass. Y'all was so ready to be the bot ass. I was like, what the fuck? So immediately my legs started shaking and she walked away. And then I look at my mama and my mama looking at me and we making this little eye contact. Like, we got this little twin thing, eye contact thing. So we looking at each other and I already knew she knew it was up. So I already knew, like, mama, yeah, like they playing us. So I block him right after. And then the head took a pause on the game and he tried to come walk up to me and I was
outraged. And like, checks, I was like, you look fucking not. Checks, I was like, you look fucking not.
You're not finna talk to me. Hell to the no. Back up. So, you know, game over. Tell my brother, let's go, because we don't associate with y'all no more. Bye. Bye. Adios. So, I had texted him when I got home and I was like, is there anything you want to tell me? So he was like, no. So I was like, you sure? He was like, yeah. So I was like, you sure, you sure? He was like, yeah. So I was like, you ain't got no girlfriend? So he's like, no, I'm single. So I was like, oh. So he's like, I know why you asked that. So I was like, bitch, if you knew why I asked it, then why would you ask me why I asked that, bitch? So I was like, well, it seems to me you got a girlfriend. And then he was like, well, I'm single and I do what I want. I don't have to tell nobody. And I was like, first. Fucking my woman, not about to do is catch an attitude with me. So before I would have said anything rude, because I know me, I would have hurt his little feelings. I hit that block button so quick. I ain't never seen my fingers stay. I was like, you know what, I was mad that whole night. I said, you done fucked up my whole day. You done made me mad. I was having a good day, a good productive day. And then look what you did. So I was just like, Pooh Bear. Like, that name kept going through my head. I was like, Pooh Bear. I was like, this bitch called him Pooh Bear. And it's not that, like, I mean, call a bitch, because she not a bitch. She really a good person. But it's just the fact that she don't know. And I'm pretty sure she don't know to this day, because I'm pretty sure that they still go out. But it's like, y'all don't. Like, my whole thing is, and it's not just him, it's like plenty of dudes that I know. And girls too, if you know that you are not ready to be in a committed relationship, then why get in one? I would have respected you if you was like, man, I got a girlfriend. You didn't even have to DM me. Man, I got a girlfriend, you know, but we could be friends. Or we could just, you know, chill. We could kick it. I'd have been honest with you. I would have respected you if you was like, you just wanted to fuck. I would have told you no. But I would have respected you because that's all you wanted to do. But you led me on thinking that, oh, we could be friends and we're going to be something more. And then you leave this month. He leave in December. So I was like, So I was just mad. I was just like, so we really out here leading people on, thinking that we the shit's not eating one night. And I was like, what we not finna do? And I was just like, oh my god, I come back. So I was just like, so this what we doing? We leading people on. I was like thinking whatever your shit. But yeah, I guess this was lesson learned that you really, really, truly, 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 truly get to know the nigga before you know you just jump in and think that you're the only female. Because I really, truly feel bad. But at the same time, I'm not going to wish the worst on him because there's a devil talking, you feel me? So, you know, like I've always been saying, I wish him the best of luck. Hope football go well. Hope school go well. Hope his family go well. I hope he have the best life. Like, if you ever watch this and you catch on, I hope you live your best life, sir. Hope you and your girlfriend get married. Hope y'all have kids. And I hope y'all live y'all best life. You feel me? Because at the end of the day, I know damn well, but I know I ain't ready for a relationship. I ain't hopping in shiz and I eat. You feel me? Like, if I know I'm going to hold around, nigga, you either go wait or you go back the fuck up. I don't know what to tell you, but I tell people that all the time because niggas just be assuming that I have hoes. First of all, I'm too slow to have hoes. I don't, like, I could show y'all, like, I have so many unsaved messages, like, unsaved numbers that be texting me, and to the point where I'd be like, who's this? Like, who's you? And they be sending me pictures and stuff, and I'd be like, oh, hi. But I know if I'm not ready for a relationship, I'm not about to put myself in one to where I'm leading people on. That's how people, like, this is why we got the Lifetime movies that we got now, with females are stabbing they niggas in the neck and in the leg because you leading us on. Like, stop. Like, you don't get tired of that? Like, it's 2018. Like, we about to be in 2019 and you still can't realize that you're not ready for a relationship. Like, and it just made me so mad. And I was like, this nigga really out here thinking that he the shit's not he, but he not. I was just like, bitch. I was like, but you know what? You thought you got the best of me, but you didn't. I'm still standing.
My chick bad. My chick hood. My chick do stuff that your chick wish she could. My chick bad. My chick hood. My chick do stuff that your chick wish she could. My chick bad. Baddy, baddy, dick.
Still a bad. I'm a bad. Say a lot of fun. She's in the back, hey, I know how to go and get it back, you know? So, you know, I'm still standing, I'm still doing me, you know? I was hurt at the time, but now, you know, I kind of brushed that off because can't be mad forever, you know? He did what he did, and I can't get past this, so I just wish him the best of luck, and I wish his girlfriend the best of luck, and if she find out, I hope he give her the truth and not the lie, because it's just going to make it worse for me, so I just don't understand why he did it. But, you know, shit happens. So, you know, life learned lesson. Hope y'all watch this, you know, like, comment, and subscribe, you know, you're filming. And if you ever been in a situation before or similar, you know, let me know, you know, comment down below. And just let me know what y'all did to deal with the situation, you know, because, I mean, I don't know if I did it in a mature way, but I think I've handled it mature way, you know. I didn't blow up his phone or I didn't text him constantly, you know. I just left him alone because, I mean, I found it pointless. Like, I'm going to blow up your phone and do all this and for what? Because you're not going to change how you feel. Like, you played me. So, it's like... And then you just thought I was going to stay talking to you after that, nigga. You is blocked. But, you know, I'm nothing against you, you know. You living your best life. I'm happy for you. I round you applause. You just ain't gonna ever play me again, and you're never gonna come back in my life again, because once you're gone, you're gone. Bye, bye, my nigga. Bye, bye. But yeah, hope y'all like this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Bye, y'all.